the horse professor. It can often take anything up to 8, 10 or more years for an apprentice to become a rider. Correct posture in the saddle is the basis and starting point for all equestrian skills. It requires a lifetime's practice. This is the target of all their endeavors, the artists on the way to their appearance, the performance. Even the city traffic stops for them. Here now we see the goal of dressage, to create a work of art through the unison of horse and rider in movement, lavishly poetic, yet contained within the stringent Baroque precepts of decorative figures performed with unswerving precision. Except for the quadrille, supreme art holds sway in free form, peaking in individual tour de force in all the passages and movements of the haute école. Tradition requires that one dark Lipizzaner should also take part, a reminder of the days when the stallions were not only white.
Thank you.
great moment. Horse and rider connected only by the red ribbon of the long rein, the horse in disciplined freedom. Only a superbly trained stallion can also master all the feats of the Otikol without his rider. Pas de deux. Two stallions as mirror-inverted moving images. This is the very epitome of precision. Elegance and grace perfectly coordinated and matched. Above the ground. These are the postures and jumps imitated from nature. All these movements derive from the piaf, on the rein or ridden. Horse and rider blend to a single artistic personality. The Spanish Riding School is the only and the last institution which fosters classical dressage in its purest form. Yet even great art endures only for a moment. It vanishes like the dying tones of music. There can be true understanding between humans and horses if we're prepared to bring tolerance and friendship to our perception of the way a horse thinks and feels, and to enlist it as man's partner without depriving it of its innermost nature. This is the message of the majestic white horses, the Lipizzanas of the Spanish Riding School.